Good morning, everybody. We're going to start. Please, can you tell me if you can receive my audio well, please? Thank you very much. Hello, hello, can you receive me well? Hello.
Yes, teacher.
All right. Thank you. So let's proceed with the role. Closing here. Start your cameras, please. The students whose last name are with letter A, B, C to start calling you. Let's start with the recording here.
Recording in progress.
Start recording the session that corresponds to Monday, November 15th. Reduce here the size of this. Repeat your name. So, for example, in my case, it would be Abrego Amaya Teaga.
Jesús Arch.
Next. Ayala Baella Calderón.
Manuel Baella present.
Very good. Campos Castro. Campos Villena. Castro Campos, Castro Vega.
Castro Vega present.
Castro Vega present. Turning on your cameras if your last name is with letter C, D, E. Next, Chocos Contreras Dextre.
Eduardo Contreras, present teacher.
Thank you very much. Díaz Felices Flores.
Felices present, teacher.
Donald Felices present. Next. Garay García Garcilaso.
Cristian Díaz present, teacher.
Cristian Díaz present. Next. González Guevara Heredia. Anybody? Continue. Hidalgo Wincho Jiménez. No.
Andrés Hidalgo present.
Andrés Hidalgo present. Okay. If your last name is with letter J, L, M, turn on your cameras, please. I'm going to proceed calling you. Yaja Yamaponca Mar.
John Yaja present, teacher.
John Yaja, correct. Okay. Nobody else? Okay. Melgarejo Montes Caja Montes Jaramillo.
Montes Caja present.
Montes Caja present. Morales Naivares Ore.
Naivares present, dicho.
Naivares present, correct. Osorio Pacotay Pineda.
Osorio present.
Blas Osorio present. Omalia Quispe Rodríguez. Anybody? No. Rojas Saavedra Sacaco.
Rojas
present. Saavedra present. Saavedra present, teacher.
Carlos Rojas present.
Takako present, teacher.
Okay, again. I only recognize Carlos Rojas present. Yeah. Anybody else?
Saavedra teacher present. José Rodríguez present. I'm here.
Takako present, teacher.
Remember Saavedra, that is name and last name. So Sakai Saavedra o Saavedra here present. Next, there is another person who's speaking. Sorry.
Takako present, teacher.
Felix Takako. Remember name and last name, please. So I have, in conclusion, I have Carlos Rojas present, Sakadi Saavedra present, Felix Akako present. Anybody else? Nobody else.
Pinedo present, ingeniero.
Edwin Pinedo present. Next. Segur Silva Solís. Anybody? Finally, Vega Ventosilla.
Anthony Solís Vega. Present. Anthony Solís present.
Anthony Solís present. Finally, Vega Ventosilla Vergara Joplac.
Luis Vega present, teacher.
Okay.
Yair Ventosilla present, teacher.
Okay, thank you. Nobody else. So I have a total of 19 people. And according to Zoom, we are 21.
Teacher.
Two people who didn't answer. Yes?
José Rodríguez present, teacher.
José Rodríguez. Okay, José Rodríguez, and there is one more student there, or you are using two devices. José Manuel Rodríguez, correct. Present. Nobody else? I assume that somebody is using two devices to be connected. So, thank you very much. Let me access to a our books. Today we have jazz class, so no big deal for that. And we have to continue with, we reached, we were with diodes, right? Diodes, if you can help me, my link is in here. Who's our link student is Mr. Vega. What was the last page we did?
Page 24.
Could we finish with that, or did we finish?
Yes.
Okay. The exercises, task number 6. I'm going to share the screen with you. Then I'm going to pay attention to the chat in order to check people who arrive late. Even myself, I had some delay of 4 minutes or 5 minutes, so it's logical.
We did task number 5.
That's fine. Okay, correct. Task number 5, that is the... okay, how the diodes are decoded. Now, let's go with linking facts and ideas. That corresponds to how to connect ideas with the same subject itself. We call these linkers or linking expressions relative pronouns. So I'm going to put here linking facts and ideas. Well, this is through relative pronouns. Relative pronouns plus two. Preposition. Relative pronouns and two. No, probably and also two. So the relative pronouns are, for example, which. which, that, and also to indicate purpose. Okay. Now, how to do this? When we have common subjects like resistors are electronic components, and resistors are used to add resistance to a circuit, we can connect the two ideas by using the relative pronoun which means el cual o la cual. But that which may reference to the previous noun that was mentioned. In this case, resistors. It doesn't matter if it is singular or plural. For example, resistors is plural, but we use which. If you say a resistor is an electronic component, which, it would be the same. So the relative pronoun which is used for singular or plural. And to is going to indicate purpose. Where to put this linking expression or linking word? You can first, you need to have the same subject or the same noun in both sentences so that you can connect one to another. You discover that it's the same subject talking about that, and you say, you can copy practically the first, you can copy practically the first or the expression. This is the first because it's the definition. Because first, we have to start that the primary idea is that resistors are electronic components. After that, we have some additional information. Resistors are used to add resistance to a circuit. So first is what they are, and then what they do. So this is what they are. Resistors are electronic components. Is the first idea. And then what they do, the function, they add resistance to a circuit. How to connect this? This which refers to components, electronic components. But these components are the resistors that we originally mentioned. I told you that doesn't matter plural or singular. Sorry, let me activate my camera. I turned off because I was calling the attendance. Doesn't matter if it is singular or plural. The thing is that it's a noun. And as a noun, it can be replaced by which in this case. That, as I told you in Spanish, is el cual o la cual. So, which add resistance to a circuit is a relative clause. As we use here a relative pronoun, all the sentence that is affected, after that, this is all the sentence that comes after that is called a clause. I'm going to copy that. And this relative clause contains a verb plus a complement. The subject itself, the subject is the relative pronoun. So if you ask yourself, and what is the subject in this sentence? The subject is which add resistance to circuit. So that is the way that we can connect. First, we start with the definition, number one, definition, and then the function. When we have, for example, different subjects, but the same object and then the same subject in the other, for example, like this, very accurate resistors are used in instruments. So they say very accurate resistors. These resistors are mean these resistors. Finally, you are talking about these very exact or very accurate resistors. So it's the same. You can add which are expensive, by the way. But there is one difference between this clause. There is a difference between number one here, or let's say letter A.
tengo una tele. ¿Cuándo Xucha va a subir las notas? A la...
Please, you can mute your microphones if you have noise near you. This sentence or this clause, it's not a sentence, it's a clause. It's different from the term. Let me see, guys. Thank you very much. Okay. It's very different for one reason. In letter B, imagine that we omit this information. What happens if we just eliminate this? It's a complete idea. So if we add some information like, by the way, por si acaso, by the way, they are expensive, you are giving extra information that is not really relevant to understand the global idea that they are using instruments. On the other hand, which add resistance to a circuit, you have some clause or some statement that is not complete because you say resistors are electronic components. Yes, correct. But what else? No, it's not complete. It's like Peru is in South America. Yes, and what else? Or you can also say UNI is a university. Uh-huh. What else? So the idea is not complete. For this case that we need to put this information because it's mandatory, we call this that this relative clause is a defining relative clause. This relative clause, by the way, is defining relative clause. Components which add resistance to circuit, correct? Here, says which are expensive is a non-defining. If we have defining, then we have non-defining relative clause. Defining relative clause. That means that it is only a detail. If you want to consider, you can consider. If you don't want to consider, don't consider it. And that's it. How do you differentiate defining with non-defining? Apart from the context that indicates this information is really relevant and necessary, this information is just a detail, not mandatory. You separate that with commas. So they say very accurate resistors is here. They say very accurate resistors, comma, which are expensive, comma, are using instruments. The commas indicate you that this information is not relative. So at the same time, when you form your statement, you have to know whether to put the commas or not. So whether the information is defining or non-defining. That is with which, relative pronouns and relative clauses using which. Now, clear drawings. Oh, wait. Let me check the chat.
Teacher.
Yes?
In the first case, it could be which are used to add or no?
In the first case, can we use, sorry?
In the first case, it could be which are used to add?
Which I used to add. Which are used to add? Yes, of course. Yes. You can use which are used to add resistance to circuit. Yes, Mr. Hidalgo, you can use that. What I thought is that your question was, so the question is, in some books, when I studied about the use of which, they indicate that which is that. Is it true? Can we use that? You can use that only for this case. Mm-hmm. This is true for this. So this is true for defining relative clauses. So you can say resistors are electronic components which add resistance to a circuit. Or resistors are electronic components that add resistors are circuited. Or, as Mr. Hidalgo said, resistors are electronic components which or that are used to add resistance to circuit. In the example, they preferred not to use R. Why not? Because you are repeating the same verb in a very short sentence. You are producing redundancy. That is called in English redundancy. It's not very good in English to repeat words, no? So you said resistors are electronic components. And then you mentioned again, which are used to add resistance, it's redundant. So to avoid that redundancy, they prefer to say which add resistance to circuit. Remember that in English, talking about the words, what is less is better. No? Mientras menos palabras, mejor. Is the opposite of Spanish. In Spanish is, cuanto más palabras, mejor. So the more is better. No, in English is the opposite. Concise and specific is much better than, let's say, full of words or expressions to mention the same thing. So next here. In the case of which, for non-defining relative clauses, that is not possible. So here, in order to remember, can we use that here? Which is the same of as that in this case? The answer, to be very specific with this, is no. Okay, we only use which, not that, in non-defining relative clauses. And it happens also with who. You know that when using relative clauses, who and that is possible to be accepted in different circumstances. That is only for defining relative clauses. That happens only for defining relative clause, that is the use of which or who to indicate some function or some additional information of the noun or the subject in this case. For non-defining relative clauses, that which replaces which or who is not possible, okay? Now, let's continue with the clearing drawings here in order to continue with the exercises. And what happened to two? Two indicates purpose, no? So why do you do this with the purpose of getting something? So let's go to the applications. It says a resistor is a component, right? Definition. A resistor is used to add resistance to a circuit. So it's the same as we had in the example. Number two, I'm not going to do number one because the example is here. Mouse. The example is this, practically. Next, number two says, carbon resistors are made of compressed graphite. Carbon resistors are made of compressed graphite. The graphite is formed into small tubes. So we can say how to connect them. First, I have to locate where is the speech that is being repeated. Uh-huh. And we have carbon resistors are made of compressed graphite. And here, the graphite that is repeated again. Uh-huh. So here, I will have to add which. Okay, how can we do this? I can say, or we can say, carbon resistors. You just copy the same. Carbon resistors are made of compressed graphite. Graphite, that is an element that we can use with which, because it's an object. So which is formed into small tubes. And then I have the two sentences connected. The two sentences connected in only one. Carbon resistors are made of compressed graphite, which is formed into small tubes. With commas, No. Ni without commas. Now, number three uses two. The difference is that now we are going to talk about the purpose, not the noun, the purpose. In the previous one, we made reference of graphite. So this which, that is a relative pronoun, when you say, when you wonder to yourself, relative pronoun. So it made relevance, or it made reference to something that was mentioned before. Yes. What was that information mentioned before? In this case, graphite. Graphite was mentioned before. Now, using two, we have a ceramic coating is applied. A ceramic coating is applied over the graphite. But what is the intention? What is the purpose of applying this ceramic coating? Why do they apply that? The second part explains the ceramic coating insulates the graphite. So over the graphite, two, that is the purpose. To insulate, I go directly to the verb because that is the purpose, to insulate. Now, you help me here. What happens if I repeat graphite again? And I say a ceramic coating is applied over the graphite to insulate the graphite. Does it sound well to you? ¿Suena bien? What do you think? I just mentioned you something about redundancy. Redundancy is when you repeat words. And when you repeat words in English, it's not very good. So we are creating redundancy here. A ceramic coating is applied over the graphite to insulate the graphite again. So we have to find something in order to replace this, the graphite. How can I replace that? Ceramic coating is applied over the graphite to insulate what? Anybody? You can use the chat, you can speak, you can raise your hands. Anybody?
It.
Exactly. Very good, Mr. Hidalgo. To insulate it, we need an object pronoun. That it made reference of graphite. And two made reference to why it is necessary. Yes. Very good. Now, let's continue with the other, with number four, five, six, seven, I think there are eight. You're going to continue with them. In order to do it, you will have, let's say, 1 minute. No, 2 minutes, 2 minutes. So clear drawings. Let's continue. 2 minutes. Four, five, six, seven. Four, five, six, seven. 2 minutes where you are. Two minutes. One minute, we check. Okay, so let's see. Coming back again. Number four is, I'm going to call some people in order to help us. Mr. Ventosilla, Yair. Your answer for number four, please, sir. Yair Ventosilla. Calling you. No connect. Okay, next volunteer. Mr. Solis, Anthony Solis. Number four, please. No, Mr. Solis. Then Mr. Osorio. Osorio Tixe. Neither. So I'm connected to only computers. Mr. Contreras Salazar. Mr. Flores. Mr. Sacaco. The idea is to connect the two phrases using two as a connector. But these two indicates the purpose. Purpose is the cause or what is the idea to do this action. So they say, the ends of the graphite are sprayed with metal. Sprayed with metal. This forms contacts. So if we need to use two, I want to think that you didn't answer because you didn't get the idea of the text. No, because you're not connected. So it says the ends of the graphite are sprayed with metal. Two, that is to maintain the base form of the verb. Notice that originally they said these forms with letter S, simple present, but when using the linking expression, two, we have to maintain the base form of the verb to form contacts. Now, number five is very similar to the example. End caps are forced on the metal sprayed ends. The caps have connecting wires attached. Mm-hmm. What is it repeated? In caps here. And we mentioned the caps here, the same caps. So now we have to connect them using which? Let me see. Volunteers, Mr. Castro Efraín. Can you help us doing that?
One second, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's good. At least you are connected. So let's see. And caps are forced on the metal sprayed ends. The caps have connecting wires attached.
Maybe which are forced on the metal sprayed ends.
Mm-hmm. So let's see.
The second is which have connecting wires at each.
So ends caps are forced on the metal spray ends, which have connecting wires attached. Okay, thank you very much, Mr. Castro. The point here is where to put that that information, that additional information. If you notice, you see that the second statement is non-defining relative clause. That means that is additional information, not so relevant in order to understand the global situation here. Why not? Because if you say end caps are forced on the metal spray ends, that is a statement that is complete. If you just want to add the caps have connecting wires attached, is by the way, no, just in case, the caps have connecting wires attached. It's just a detail. So you can say end caps, which have connecting wires attached, comma, are forced on the metal sprayed end points. This information that we are writing to the first is an statement that we call non-defining clause. So we can omit this and nothing happens. The global idea is still clear. We can omit this. That is why I put between commas. No? We can say end caps are forced on the metal spray ends. No? Or I can also say end caps which have connecting wires attached are forced on the metal spray ends as a detail. Normally, which or that or who, depending on the type of relative clause that you are going to use, is very connected to the previous noun or the noun that it is making reference of. In this case, end caps. Why I cannot put next to ends? Because here these ends are a little different from the end caps. They are different because these ends are different from ends of the terminal, which are different group of elements. That finally they get together and they form only one, that is different. But they are two separated things. That is why I cannot put which after ends. Number six indicates the purpose to do something. So they say the ceramic is marked with color bands. The bands indicate the value and tolerance. Because here they ask us to use two, we have to make the reference of two for the purpose or the intention, not for the noun phrase. So I'm going to call somebody. Help us here, please. Andrea Maya, I'm going to start with you or for you. When they say the ceramic is marked, the ceramic is marked with color like British English. What is the idea of marking this ceramic with color bands? Anybody? Probably Mr. Amaya cannot answer, but anybody in the group? Nicole, Amalia.
Yes, teacher.
Well, Steven. Yes? Okay. Thank you very much for your participation.
To indicate the value and tolerance.
Exactly, sir. To indicate who was the person who spoke?
Rojas, teacher. Okay.
Mr. Rojas. Okay. Carlos Rojas. The ceramic is marked with color bands to what?
To indicate the value and the tolerance.
The value and the tolerance. Yes, that is. As simple as that. Very good. Thank you very much. Now, number seven, the last one. Resistors are made in a range of preferred values. These values meet all values are the same values that they mention on the second statement, these values. How to connect them using which? Is that additional? No, that is part of a global statement. No? Resistors are made in a range of preferred values. Giving information about these preferred values, these values meet all the needs of circuit designs. So we can say, in order to this unit, resistors are made in a range of preferred values, which meet, and then I continue just writing, meet needs, all the needs of circuit designers. Sir, can I use instead of which to? Yes, imagine that the book, the exercise says only use which or use to in order to connect the two phrases. Yes, you can see resistors are made in a range of preferred values to meet all the needs of circuit designers. I prefer to use which here, not only because the books indicate that, but also because we have the common noun. Notice that this noun in the first statement is the object. Resistors are made in a range of preferred values, the object. But in the second one is the subject. These values meet all the needs of circuit designs. Okay, so that is why we use which after mentioning preferred values. So to remember this in a different way, we use which, yes, but which made reference of preferred values. We use to, okay, to indicates the purpose, to indicate. We use which, that which made reference of end caps. The ends of the graphite are sprayed with metal to form. So what is the idea of these two? What is the purpose? To plus form. To form contacts. Okay, to remember what is the reference here. Thank you very much. So officially we finish with this unit. Clear drawings. Clear drawings and stop sharing in order to continue with our next topic. The next topic is unit number 5, right? The one that continues. Share screen again. And here you're going to work more actively. Because now this unit is more for you than for the teacher to participate, which is going to be good for me because I have certain problems with my motor. So let's see. Batteries. You have this first expression here. What is the expression? Here. 20 billion batteries are sold every year. Considering that the book is not new, so we are talking about some years ago. Today, the use of batteries has definitely multiplied much more. Why? Because of new devices that depend on the use of batteries. Batteries are called this portable form of energy that we have in general ways. In Spanish, we call pila, batería, celda, etc. But in English, it's just battery or battery cell. Why do you think this message is true? Or what do you think this statement is true? What different kinds of batteries are there? List some of the things you use with contains batteries, and then compare with someone else. The idea is to make a list of 20. Before the pandemic, we reached 20. Yes, 20. So 20 devices, 20 things, 20 objects that require batteries. That is what we're going to do. Let me see, where is annotation? So the idea is that in your groups, because now you're going to work in, you have to form a list of the maximum number of items. The idea is to arrive to 20 items, which use batteries. For example, sir, for example, you can say torches. Torches is what we cell phones. You know that our cell phones, they use batteries. Then we are going with the material or the 20 objects that use batteries. We are going to work this in breakout rooms. So let's see. Now everybody connects because I understand that your microphone is not in good condition, but joining the class is part of the idea. How many people? Three per group, okay? Three per group. So that you can contribute, use dictionary, Google, whatever you want. You're going to have 4 minutes. Let's see 4 minutes, how many you get. Options. How long? 4 minutes, correct. Recording in progress. Linternas, cell phones. Number three, anybody?
Radios.
We are 23 people, so if you speak quickly and only one expression, we can finish this in 1 minute, practically. Yes, Mr. Rojas, you said?
Yes, teacher, radios.
Radios. Portable radios. Portable radios.
Cameras, teacher.
Okay. Number four, cameras. Correct. Next, number five. Anybody? Again?
Headphones.
Again? Cell phones? Cell phones is there.
Headphones.
Headphones. But what headphones? Because
wireless headphones.
Okay, that's different. Wireless headphones. I'm going to put earphones. Okay. You know that earphones are more common. So that headphone is like this. Earphone is just the earphones or headphones. But both of them headphones are or uses this Bluetooth. Yes. Next, number six.
Teacher, cars.
Cars, correct. Cars, automobiles. So, number seven, watches, wristwatch. Wrist, which is redundant because a watch is wrist, definitely. Next.
What else? Controller.
Remotes. Remotes in general, not only for TV. Yes. Number nine. Anybody? Torch, cell phones, portable radios, cameras, earphones or headphones, wireless.
Laptops.
Laptops. I listen laptops. Somebody said something else?
Clocks, teacher.
Clothes. Clothes. What type of clocks? Clothes? Ah, clocks. Mm-hmm. Okay, yes, clocks. Today, there are no spring clothes. But we can say quartz clocks. Okay, yes. What else?
Calculators,
very good. 13.
Teacher, wireless mouse.
Okay. For keyboards. Okay, next, 14. The next month is December. December 25th.
Electronic scooter.
Okay, electronic scooter. I was introducing presents in general, but you talk about probably your own present, electronic scooters. More than electronic, I would say they are electric. Huh? But okay, electronic scooter. What else?
Some toys.
I'm going to put electric because I remember electric scooters. Yes, sorry, the last person said?
Some toys.
Toys,
or
yes.
Toys in general.
Now, let's be careful with this. These toys could be electric toys. Electric. Because there are mechanical toys as well. No? So electric toys with lights, for example.
Teacher, in this case, yes. I think it's electronic toys because they are used in DC electric.
Okay, electronic toys. All right. Number 16. That is a good question. Electric or electronic? What is my cell phone? Is it here? Okay, 16. We are near the end. Because I receive some electronic voice. Also, so could be electric or electronic. Mm-hmm. Okay, correct. Next, si sin electric or electronic toys. Next, 16, what do we have?
Alarms.
Alarms, of course. Alarms. Alarm systems run on batteries just in case somebody decides to cut off the electric input. Yes, 17.
Electric bicycle.
Okay. Scooters, bicycles, vehicles.
Portable battery. I don't know where it is. It's a battery, but use a battery.
That is I think it's a battery bank. Let me check that. Battery bank. Yes. What do they call this in general? Portable power banks is portable power bank. Portable power bank. That is what we call this external batteries. Number 18.
Teacher.
Imagine. Yes.
Game Boy.
Game Boy is in the category of electronic toys. Game Boy. These portable units. Other.
Okay.
Teacher. Imagine it could be smartwatches, teacher.
Sorry, again.
It could be shaver.
Yes, but the name is not shaver, it's razor. And we have to say portable because they can be connected as well. No? Portable electric razor. Portable electric razor. Yes. 19. We are very close to the end.
Smartwatches, teacher.
Yeah, but watch is number 7. Imagine that you are studying right now. Imagine that we return to classes. And there is a blackout. Blackout is apagón. No, there is a blackout there at the faculty. Is the faculty or is the school in total darkness? No, sir. Why not? Because they use something. Okay, Mr. Morales, wireless fans. Yes. Or electric fans. Yes. Portable electric fans. Okay, accepted. But how do you call these lights that when there is a interruption of electricity, automatically they turn on? How do you call that in English?
Security lights.
Security light? No, you are translating too much. You are forcing the language. How do you call that? More than security is emergency. Because of the time I'm going to run. It's an emergency lights. Emergency lights. Those are these backup lights that permit you to at least leave the place. And the other, I'm going to use Mr. Morales' idea. You have electric or wireless fans. Wireless fans or cordless phones also. cordless phones. But Mr. Acuña, you said cell phones. Yeah, but cordless phone is different from cordless or from cell phone. The cell phone uses the cellular technology, you know, the tower that receives the signal and emits the signal somewhere else. The cordless phone is the telephone that we may have in our house, but it doesn't use a cord to be connected to one place. So you can speak from the living room, the kitchen. You can go to your bedroom, for example, and continue speaking using this phone with one base. That is cordless phone. And wireless fan, these are batteries, battery fans that some people use specifically in summer. And I remember the academy was full of these devices with the students. So, yes. Okay, very good. Thank you very much. We completed the 20. You suffered a little, huh? Now, there are some technologies for these kinds of batteries. Yes, depending on the type of cell, the positive electrode, the negative electrode, the example of use, etc. There is an audio for this. I'm going to share the audio via Univirtual. So right now we are going to skip this task because we are going to solve it. And I'm going to share with you the solution from the audio. All right, now let's go with the next part. Because after this, we have a circuit to check that is the use of batteries in a battery charger. And that is used through the description of components. So we have a lot of information here to do. Let's see, little by little and on the go. First, we have a text where we establish two different types of cells, all types. Huh? Today, they use the most common is ion lithium cells. But in the past, they use zinc carbon cells, and not so past, they are still in use, and NiCad cells or NiCad cadmium cells. And here we have the description. The idea is how to go, the intention is how to go from the text. How to go from the text itself to a, come on. How to go from the text to a chart, a summary chart. That is the idea. So let's go. Zinc carbon cell says it has zinc negative electrode, a manganese dioxide positive electrode. The electrolyte is a solution of ammonium chloride. The carbon rod, that is the carbon column, core is in contact with the positive electrode, but is not involved in the chemical reaction. And it's called the current collector, the EMF. What is EMF? That is a question for you. EMF. Something that you studied in physics.
Yes. Electromagnetic force?
Electro, yes, but not magnetic. And force, yes, but, sorry, electro or electric. In some cases they call electric.
Well,
force, yes, but not magnetic.
Mechanic.
Why don't you just Google it? It's not a
test. Let's do motion.
Exactly, motion, electric motion force. The units that we use for EMF is volts. Remember that we studied that in physics? So that is, next. They say, but it's not involved in the chemical reaction. It's called the current collector. The EMF is 1.5 volts, and the internal resistance is about 0.5 ohms. This is the most popular cell for low current or occasional use. For example, remember, it is, for example, in torches. So that is the zinc cell. The electrolyte, where is the electrolyte here? Ammonium chloride. But chloride with CH. H, 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 here. Okay. ammonium chloride. Now, the EMF here is 1.5 volts. 1.5 volts. Well, B, not to confuse you. Next, the NiCad cell has, it says, the electrodes are nickel and cadmium. Nickel, the pronunciation is nickel, but when you use the abbreviation, it's NiCad. And the electrolyte is potassium hydroxide. Okay, so here we can put potassium, double S, potassium, hydroxide, hydroxide. Next, what is the EMF here? They say 1.2, so it's less, 1.2 volts. And they say it is made in the same size as the primary cell. For example, HP2, PP3, so these are what we call the button types, the types of batteries that we use in our watches, if you use a watch in the past. Also available, high currents can be supplied, recharging must be a constant, so these nickel cadmium cells or nickel cadmium cells are rechargeable type of cells used in all telephones or cell phones. Yes, electromotive, yes, oh, electromotion, I remember. Let's see, but if it is, let me confirm this. Somebody, Mr. or Miss Omalia, has made a comment here. Let me see. EMF. EMF. Definition and formulas. Definition and formula. Maximum work done per chair, per unit charge. Today for the point, yes. Electromotive force, yes, Nicole, thank you very much. So, selecting here, electromotive, and it's together, huh? It's together, it's connected to one word, electromotive. Force, electromotive force. Please check that, please, everybody. Electromotive force, EMF. That is the maximum work done per unit charge to take charge from one point to another. Yes. In physics. That is equal to the terminal potential difference when no current flows. That is the definition for electromotive force. Thank you very much, Nicole. Now, let's continue with. So, going from the text, again, going from the text to the chart is what we need or what they said here. Okay. And whether to use one or the other. This is what we have in volts or the EMF. Okay, thank you very much. Now, let's continue with clear drawings here. And let's go with task number 5 is how to label the diagram of a zinc carbon cell with these terms. The zinc can, the carbon collector, the jacket, the carbon rod, the positive electrode, the electrolyte, etc. So you're going to do this, let's see, in threes again, in order to discover how it is done. But only 3 minutes, okay? 3 minutes, and quickly. You can look for the information on Google. It's not a secret here. The idea is to be in the group in order to discuss letter A is number one, number two. And the problem here is that we don't have the lines so clear. So let me put them clear for you. Let me see, number 4. Number 1 is this. Number two is this. You put them in order. Number three is this. Okay. And number four. Yeah, like this. So in order to have it clear, and here number four is the external part. Okay, that is. So let's get in groups, breakout rooms, 3 minutes only, and open.
Recording in progress.
out of 20 people, we must get the answer for this. We have the zinc can, we have the current collector, we have the jacket, we have the carbon rod, the positive electrode, the electrolyte. So what is it? What is
the
what?
Carbon rod, teacher?
The carbon rod, correct. And the carbon rod is very connected to carbon rod. Is very connected also, not to copy the same, letter D, but also the positive electrode, letter E, because it's very connected to it. Now, number two, what is that external part, number two?
Teacher, number two is electrolyte.
Number two is electrolyte. The electrolyte is something more external than the carbon itself, because we need, the electrolyte is this thin plate, or this number three that I indicated, number three here. That is the electrolyte. That is letter F.
I thought that was the zinc can. Well, on internet that says...
No, the zinc is external. The zinc is external, is this, letter A.
But the jacket is not the external, like the physical part. So it would be the four jacket and the three zinc can and two electrolyte. Oh, well, that's what I found on internet.
This is the zinc can, and the zinc can is also the... the jacket that you mentioned, yes. It's not mentioned here, but it's a good,
it's here. Yeah.
The jacket is made of zinc. Well, some elements, no, not pure zinc. Letter C is A and C. The electrolyte is here, looks like the external, but this is the manganese oxide. And in this case, is the we have the current collector is there, because we have zinc can AC current collector. We haven't used that. The carbon rod is the core itself. The positive electrode that is very connected. The positive electrode is this that is very connected to the zinc can. The electrolyte we did with letter F. Letter E, yes. So the only thing that we have or that we need to put is letter B, that is a current collector here. So collects the current from the electrolyte and the carbon rod. That is the diagram of what do you have there? Sorry, who was the lady who's speaking?
Oh, me, Nicole.
Yes. Nicole, what, any difference that you found?
Actually, I found that letter C with the jacket was only like the external part. So number four correct. Would be just C. And for me, mm-hmm. or at least in the picture that I found on the internet, letter, where is zinc can, letter A would be just number three, because it's like inside of the jacket. And number two would be electrolyte.
The electrolyte is not so connected to the carbon. That is a problem here.
I found that it was really like near each other.
What is the source that you have?
Okay, let me check. Please.
Share the source to check it.
Oh, okay. I thought I was going to share the screen. Put a link. Okay, link here.
Yeah, put in the chat in order to check. Okay. Electric for you. Okay, let's see. I'm here, right here. Yes. Am I sharing that or no?
No, you're not.
No? Okay, you share this. Okay, let's see. Let's evaluate that.
Yeah, so in the second image,
uh-huh.
right one, you can see that the carbon rod, that is the main part, like the central part, is near to the electrolyte plus and the electrolyte itself.
The polarizing mix and the electrolyte, but check.
Yeah.
You have the electrolyte, well, they say electrolyte plus because it's the polarizing mix. And then the other is the electrolyte, is the excellent, the electrolyte itself, this one.
Yeah, but then the zinc can that is like below that.
Ah, well.
Yeah. Yes. And you can see the jacket also.
Yes. Correct. We can say that this is a more realistic image because you know there are more layers, if you can appreciate there. Less than in the image that I showed you, no? That the book shows you, where you have the very basic pattern. For example, here, you have the external electrolyte and then right connected, which is real, the electrolyte plus. Including you have a sealant there, so it's not connected. So this graph is more, let's say, more real. The brace yes, it's more complete and the negative connection there. What we have is the zinc can and the insulating jacket. For example, the insulating jacket is the paint that we have over the zinc can, because when you touch the battery itself, you notice that there is some kind of paint over that. That is the insulating jacket. But here in the basic graph, we have only the jacket as the cover or the container of all the elements. Yes, this is a more complete scheme or schematic. For the exercise of the book, we have just those labels that are the ones that I show you here. But very valid. Thank you very much for the control. I don't know if because I shared, I continue having this. No, I lost it. But this is a more basic graph of the battery itself. The one that you presented is more complete indeed. Thank you very much. Now let's continue with the language study, 30 minutes. Let's see. How to describe components. Two questions may be needed. First, what they are called, and then what they do. So first is the name of the definition, and then the function, what they do. In order to use these structures from this unit, no? It is called like this. For example, it is called a zinc carbon cell, or it is known as a zinc carbon cell. In order to provide function, we use simple present. In plural, change chemical energy into electricity. The idea is this. We have different elements and components here, from number 1 to number 10, where we need to put their names. And after doing that, we have to connect them to this, we have more. Okay. Hope that you can read from there. First, we are going to start with their names. Then we are going to connect them with their functions. So, for example, number 1, how do we call this? We call this a resistor. Then we go to number 2. How do we call this? We call this a, it's like a resistor with an arrow indicating some value.
Potentiometer.
Potentiometer. Or also called in some literature a variable resistor. Okay. Potentiometer is okay. Then number 3. What is it?
Transformer.
Correct. Yes, you know this because you use these applications, no, in order to design circuits. Number 4.
Switch.
Switch. Yes. switch. Then number five, we study them, the last class.
Diode,
yes. Number six, number six always creates a discussion. What is that?
Voltmeter.
Let me see, voltmeter. Then number seven.
Variable capacitor.
Great. Protective device for some high input. This device just get open and protects the rest of the circuit. Four letters. With letter F, the first.
Fuse.
Perfect. Fuse. Next, number nine. Is another meter. No?
Meter.
Is milli. Milli because you have the that letter M. Milliamp meter. And finally, number 10. It has two names. One is very similar to Spanish. Antenna or aerial. Antenna or aerial. Those are the names. Now, how do we connect them with their functions is different. For example, resistor, the function that we have from the list there above. So it says, varies capacitance, rectifies alternating current, adds resistance, measures very small currents, breaks a circuit, protects a circuit, varies the current in a circuit, steps AC voltage, receives RF signals, measures voltages. Which is the one for a resistor? Capacitance, no. Alternating current, rectifying, no, either. Adds resistance of circuit, yes, that is. So letter C. Number two. Measures very small currents, breaks circuits, protects a circuit, varies the current in a circuit, steps AC, receives RF, measures. What is the role of the potentiometer here? Anybody? They're working. You have studied this
letter G.
Not very long ago. Again?
Letter G varies the current in a circuit.
Yes, that is the closest one here. Okay, then the transformer. Come on, the rest of the people. Letter H. Steps AC voltages up or down, correct. Letter H. Then we have the switch. The switch.
Letter V.
Rectifies, no, rectify, not really. Rectify, remember, is to put everything from one pole to another. Again?
E.
Letter E. Breaks a circuit, yes. Breaks a circuit. Next, a diode. The person who intervened in the last one.
Steps AC voltage up or down.
No, the diode, remember, if you use a diode bridge, what is the negative signal goes up, remember? So it rectifies alternating current. letter B. The voltmeter. Voltmeter
measures voltage.
Exactly, yes. And you're not asking, right? Measures, remember, is mide. So measures voltage is, where is it? Measures voltage, J, the last one. Next, variable capacitor.
Letter E.
Letter E. Breaks a circuit?
A.
Letter A. Okay. Varies capacitance in a circuit. Yes. The fuse.
F.
Protects a circuit. Letter F. Milliammeter.
D. Letter D.
Letter E, no. Letter D, yes.
D.
Yes, letter D. Measures very small currents. Okay. The antenna or aerial? The last one.
Letter I.
Thank you very much. Receive radio frequency signals. Letter I. Yes. Okay, now, how can we put it together? So let's use a grammar. Different color. And it, then you can say, number one, C, for example. How can you connect those two? Number one, C, you can say it's called or it is called a resistor, comma, it, letter C you say, no, it adds resistance to a circuit. That's it. Next, number two. What do we have with number two? One C, two G. Not to repeat, it is called a resistor. You can say it is known, or it's known as a potentiometer. Comma, it varies the current in a circuit. So we use the two expressions that they introduce. It is, or they are called, in this case, because it's singular, a resistor, or it is known as a potentiometer, or they are called, or they are known as potentiometers. We use it here because we refer to only one. But if we had a diode bridge, for example, you would say they are called diodes. They rectify alternating current. No? You could also express like that. Connected to the function. The conclusion here is the definition can be stated with this expression. It's called a, or is known as a, but the function, it's always in simple present tense. Varies, rectifies, adds, measures, breaks. We letter S because we made reference to one element, it. So it varies, it rectifies, it adds, etc. Okay, so the exercise is very mechanical now. You have to decide which of them, how to name them, called or known, and then the function just goes connected with a call. I'm going to skip this part because after this, we have a text, which is quite long. But before going to this, we have to check the word study here. Verbs that relate pronouns, for example, if you have the verb record is grabar, how do you say grabadora? You say grabadora as a recorder. So add ER or OR to the verb to form the component. No, for example, let's say something that you know very good. You can say computer. So the verb is compute, the noun is computer. Is it in general, sir? Not really. For example, you have oscillate, but the noun is not oscillator, no, it's oscillator. Then if you have, for example, something else, measure is a verb. Can you say measurer? No, you have to say meter in this case. So it's common to have this suffix E-R-O-R, but it's not as a rule for all the things. In most of them, yes, no? Analyze, analyzer. There is another that is rectifier. But it's not an absolute or general rule. Not all of them are called in that way. So from the verb, we can obtain record recorder from oscillate. Transmit, what is the noun for transmit? How do you call this equipment that transmits some signal or signals?
Transmitter.
Transmitter.
Of course, of course. Transmitter, yes. We have seen that. I'm not going to ask because it's just there. We just did it. Transformer. Charge.
Charger.
Correct. Next, rectifier. We did this. Rectifier. Process.
Processor.
Very good. You have a microprocessor inside a computer. Amplify.
Amplifier.
This is another case, no? When you have a consonant Y, that Y is changed by IER, so amplifier. Collect. For example, in a transistor, we have base, we have source, and we have the letter C for collect what? Don't remember?
Collector,
correct. Then detect, don't tell me detective, huh? Detect. Detect what? OR or ER? What sounds to you?
Detector,
smoke detector, for example. And finally, tune. The pronunciation is different. Tuner. That is. So those are the nouns that we have from the verbs. Oscillate, oscillator, transmit, transmitter, transform, transformer, charge, charger, rectifier, process, processor, amplifier, collect, collector, detect, detector, and tune, tuner. Now, these nouns and these verbs are going to help us in order to understand what is coming. That is a long text. Let's see if we have time in order to do this. So I'm going to clear my drawings here. Yes, everybody. You know that if you have a WhatsApp group, it's very good for you to obtain the screenshots and deliver to the group so that everybody gets the idea. I'm going to pay attention to. Okay. Yes, Mr. Sakako, thank you very much for your contribution. If you don't want to interrupt, pay attention to the chat or your comments, huh? So I appreciate, for example, from the beginning, and I have to say this to stay in the record, Mr. Morales contributed, Ms. Palmalia with this observation of the battery, and also the observation of the acronym EMF, yes, electromotive force. Next, Mr. Sakako participating also with the elements. Yes, thank you very much. Now let's continue. There is a text here. I gave already time to move this and to copy that. This is a battery charger schematic. It's a general circuit. In many cases, you did this this experience in your first courses of electric or electronic circuits. So here is the explanation and how the circuit works in block stages, no? Where we have the first block that is the transformer stage, then the rectifier stage, the smoothing circuit stage, and the stabilizing circuit stage. So that we have as an income, or the input, sorry, the input is the AC mains input, and the output is the stabilized DC output, where AC is alternating current and DC is direct current. So we have a stage by stage the explanation. And here, task number 10 consists of, I have to indicate only this because of the time, I need to cut this before starting the other class, where you have to match each component or unit with the function in a battery charger. So what unit or component is connected to what? And finally, here, the writing is going to be describing a diagram. They say, describe the block diagram of the battery charger and the function of each building block. You are going to do this on UniVirtual. This is going to be your task after reading and after doing or solving the previous part that you have here. After solving this, task number 10. Task number 10, we are going to check in class. But task number 11, I'm going to revise that on UniVirtual platform. So I don't want to press you too much to read all the text in just 10 minutes, because the intention is to understand what they say in order to be ready to prepare the description of the block diagram. When they say, what is the block diagram here? The block diagram, so asking in that task is to describe how this block diagram works block per block. So what happens to the AC mains input when it enters to the transformer stage? Then what they receive and what they gets or sends out the rectifier stage. What happened at this stage? What it is sent out? What happens at the smoothing circuit? What is sent out? And what happened in the stabilized circuit? And finally, what we obtain as the form of DC. So that is what you have to explain after reading the text and after also checking some other information, some additional information. If you did that using additional information, I'm going to ask you to also insert express where your sources or what your sources were or are. Okay? So in conclusion, for the next class, so this is for our Link student, Mr. Vega, to remind us the next session. What we are going to check the next class is this, just how you connected them, because afterwards, all of you will have this task number 11 in sent via UniVirtual. Before how many did the task and how many solved is going to be until Saturday, okay? Today is 15th, so Saturday 20th. For Saturday 20th, we are going to have that is IP101N, the task. You remember that all the tasks are evaluated or considered for the speaking part. That is why I take so long in order to give you the result. Unfortunately, it demands time, but I need to do something well done. That is why I take the time. So that is going to be the task. I stop here in order to be ready with the other group. Open your cameras, please. Thank you very much for the contributions of the people that I mentioned before. Nicole Pomalia, Mr. Sakako, and obviously the people who were participating that unfortunately I didn't have the time to see your, that's why I asked you, please open your cameras when you participate in order to see where you are, who you are, because it's right there on the record, no? So Vega Ruiz, who participated? Mr. Baella, Mr. Vega, you didn't participate today. I don't know why. But every contribution is always welcome. Yes. So let's see. Open cameras, please, guys. Don't be shy. Open cameras in order to register the attendance today. We are going to come to an end. So you are there. I thought that I was talking to your computers. Interesting. Yamaponka, where are you, Mr. Yamaponka? I remember you very much because of your videos are very, I don't know if you work as a teacher, but they are very, let's say, how can I say? You have this kind of skill to transmit in, like as a teacher. Mr. Pinedo, you there? Mr. Pomalia, or Miss Pomalia, sorry, Miss Pomalia. Ah, so you're connected with two devices, Nicole. That I was just looking at the one that you have the picture. You're getting there. So Mr. Solis, nobody else? Because I don't have more time. So asking in 1, 2, try to appear, please, try to appear. 1, 2, and yes. Okay. Thank you very much. Have a nice week. See you Monday, everybody. Bye-bye.